Welcome, adventurers. Here's what happened last time on the Incorrigible party.
Shakara brings Mia and Falzern up to date on Isabella's intentions with the eyes of Dendar, while Shaft is left alone with the hag in Heracleon. Discussions of leverage arise, and Isabella shows her hand to be holding more cards than it appears, sending hordes of undead through the portal system, as General Ventrier assaults the Zexan cave with a troop of paladins.
And now, on with the show.
I'm gonna be, like, looking around. This has to stop! Shakara? I, like, look up.
So, I mean, Shakara, you could have gone anywhere you wanted. If you just kind of raised 20 feet to the ceiling, you're technically still in the silence.
I just raised up.
Okay, so you are unfortunately still in the silence, as is Falzern, as is Grimby, as is Hulsa. So nobody to hear Mia's cries but Ventrier, the paladins, and the guards. Well, next would have been the zombies, but they are toast. Ventrier, you see her fleeing along with the bodyguards, except Kilake. Kilake will basically runs over to Mia.
Yes, please, give me a hug.
And yeah, she doesn't come over to attack you again. She kind of like offers her a gauntleted hand, offers you a gauntleted hand to like help you up from the zombies, et cetera, like dusting the zombie dust
Ew.
Off of you. She's
yes.
clearly there to help you. From outside, you can all still hear the beating of the wings. Those not captured in the silence. And now you kind of hear like a humming sound. And the cave itself it violently shakes.
Oh, frick.
Dust kind of rains down from the ceiling, and a big split forms right kind of above you, Shakara, in your Dendara form. Falzern, you're next.
Can I see anything through this, or is it just sort of like a small fissure that's starting to form?
Just the latter, yeah.
Would I have noticed Mia speaking, but not heard her?
Yeah, like you can see Mia moving her mouth. Obviously, you saw her destroy all the undead.
So I think it makes sense that Falzern would know that where Mia is, there is no silence. So I am going to use half my movement to get up. And then I will move over to my left, keeping the cone still pointed.
Yeah, watch where you point that thing.
Yeah, you only have to move, yeah, exactly 15 feet, and you can hear the stomping of the paladins retreating and, you know, the crumbling dust from the ceiling.
Mia, what's going on?
I think that's Shakara, and I don't know where Shaft went. Nina's gone.
I didn't see them going the direction that I was looking. Out of this cave, they must have gone through the portal. So Falzern's going to look to Shakara, assuming that she's still under the effects of this silence, and see if he can catch her eye. Is Shakara looking his way?
Shakara has eyes for the paladins.
Now, sorry, Falzern, are you keeping the cone trained on the entrance of the cave and the fleeing paladins?
Yeah, I think I'm worried that I don't understand exactly what's going on with Shakara, so I don't want to direct it in her direction. Actually, I'm going to turn it off. I'm going to close it altogether. And I think I will, since Shakara seems to be trained on these paladins, I'm just going to take up the fight with her. I don't want to branch off from and go through the portal. I have no idea how to use it. I will cast Fireball.
20-foot radius, you could hit everybody here.
So help me, if you kill them before I have a chance to do the cool thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go up there and slap you.
Get in line.
Damn, anti-magic field screwed up two of my turns.
Okay, so deck saves all around.
All right, roll your damage.
I will roll 8d6. 31 damage for those who failed.
And your fireball just erupts over the fleeing paladins, and The normal paladins are just entirely engulfed in the severity of your flames. The only survivors are the Venturer's guard. Again, now the outside of the anti-magic field, they're replicas of the armor of Kolar, fully functioning again. And it looks like two of them failed. One kind of brushed off as much as they could as far as the effects of your spell. Are you done?
Yeah, I think I'm going to stay where I am, right behind Mia, essentially.
Oh, your meat shield. Okay. See how it is.
Shakara.
I will see the three remaining guards up ahead, and I don't know if I can get the one that's closest to me also, but I want to exhale, wither, and this blue energy will flow out of my mouth, and they all need to make dex saves. DC 18. It is a 60-foot cone.
Okay, wow, yeah, that's definitely going to be enough to get the one remaining paladin and all three of the guards. Obviously, your wither is a bit of flavor. There's nothing stopped. The silence isn't stopping your breath. Nobody can hear you say wither because you're still silenced, but you will affect everybody.
I said it
everybody.
Anyway.
Yes, of course.
Because it's on the exhale. Wither! And it comes out.
All right, we got a... Wow, we have everybody failing.
Nice.
And they will take 8d8 necrotic damage.
Oh, snap.
Wow.
This is cool.
27 for those that failed.
Wow. So this blue wave of energy, is kind of fiery looking, just this enervating wave just absolutely annihilates that one normal paladin. And you see in the span of like 5 seconds, the Venturer's guards have been bloodied severely.
I'm gonna lower down a little bit, but still stay in the air.
I don't want that breath near me.
Paladins are all dead. Thuftamar, off screen. Shaft, you see Thuftamar finally finding the correct door, the very last one at the end of the hallway. You know, he's like halfway through this glowing red, pulls back, grabs a hold of Nina, and they both disappear through it. You're up.
I follow.
Okay. With a dash, you can get to the end and through.
That's what I'll do.
Now, there are still zombies in this hallway, so you do become visible right at the beginning of your turn.
I will use my bonus action at the beginning.
Mia.
Do I know Killa K's actual name? No?
No, that's kind of their name.
I'll speak to Killer K. What? Why are they trying? Why are you? Why does Ventrier want the eyes?
They're for Isabella. She's taken over the paladins.
What happened to Samuel?
He was on the other airship. I don't know where it went.
The airship, is that what I hear flapping above us?
Yes, and she kind of points up to the fissure. That's the weapon that they're firing into the cave.
Oh, crap. Okay. Guys, the ship's above us shooting the weapon. We gotta go. We'll die here. And Mia will move toward the portal. But I can't activate it. I don't know the word or anything.
It is still aglow and still open.
Oh. Mia will step through it. It's about all my movement.
Okay, and you two are disoriented as you step in, and you do see that there are still zombies in the hallway, but not many. There's like maybe half a dozen, as they look like they were flooding out and through the openings, right? And then they kind of see you not having the benefit of being able to turn invisible, and kind of stop their progress through. So that was only your movement though, however, right? So you still do have an action in here.
If a zombie comes up on me, I'll hit it with my hammer.
Yeah, I mean, there's six within 15 feet of you.
Oh, jeez. Maybe the hammer's not going to be enough. I'll just, I'll cast Thunderwave. So they need to make constitution saves. It's a 15-foot cube, so I'll just, like, put it in front of me. As long as I'm pretty sure I don't see any friends in front of me, it's just zombies.
Yeah, and just zombies and six glowing red doorways.
Okay, I'll just try to clear the way of the zombies then with this. 14 damage.
Even the ones that save you, your Thunderwave just blows them back and they crumple, hitting the walls of this perfect, flawless stone hallway. And it is now clear of enemies.
I will hang out in here because I have no idea where I'm going. And my movement's gone anyway.
Shakara still in the silence, can't hear the humming, but those outside of it can hear the humming of the weapon again, and it fires. And Shakara, I'm going to get you to make me a dexterity saving throw, being as close to the ceiling as you are.
17.
You take 56 force damage as the weapon finally cracks through the top of this cave, and you see the beam slicing down, you know, hitting Shakara into the ground in front of you, Falzrin.
Oh boy.
Large chunks of stone are starting to crumble. You can see the knight above you from the hole that's been blasted in the top of the side of the top of this little hill that the cave is inside of. The bodyguards are going to continue to get out from this crumbling cave now, disappearing around the little hook in the entrance. Falzrin, you're up.
So I'm going to, again, like, wave my arms, run in front of Shakara to try and get her attention.
Well, it is clear that you can cast now, right, as you've done the fireball. If you did want to dispel the silence and use a slot to do that, you certainly know you can.
I mean, it'd be great if Shakara would just move.
Can I roll for perception to see if I notice him?
I mean, you can see him, yeah. I mean, you saw Mia clearly talking and saying something that you couldn't hear, right?
How does Shakara look as far as damage goes after that blow?
That blow hurt. She's faltering a little bit.
Faltering's going to run up to Shakara in this massive snake form. And I don't know how you try and, like, grab a snake by the hand to lead it. Falzrin is going to sort of, like, try and run into her line of sight, wave around, and motion pointing towards the portal. And he's going to then use the remainder of his movement to rush over toward the portal. He'll step through, I guess.
A disorientation, and you see Mia with, you know, crumpled zombies 15 feet in front of her, clearly dispatched. And every door in here is glowing red and has been flung open.
I tried to get Shakara's attention and tell her to follow us, Mia. We should wait for her.
She can't fit through this door.
Well, we don't know exactly what she can do in that form.
I don't know how long we can wait.
It should be only a moment. She might be right behind me.
Do you know which door it is?
Every time I come in here, I get completely disoriented.
Mia will just wait.
Okay. Shakara, what are you doing? Still silence is up, though.
I will see that the others went through the portal, so I will land, change back to my natural form, falter a little bit because of one level of exhaustion that I incur from doing this, motion to Grimby and Hulsa, and run through the portal.
Me and Falzrin, you see Shakara now back to her normal Hexblood form. Grimby and Hulsa each step through the portal into this flawless stone hallway.
It is this way. And I'll walk straight to the Heracleon door.
Shaft, as you had stepped through, but, you know, 12, 15 seconds before the rest of the party had, you know, transformed back, stepped into the portal system itself, you are now, like, 30 feet behind Thuftamar, hold of Nina's wrist, and again, she looks a little out of it still, kind of dazed, but you almost, like, come stepping through and into and, like, almost slide on the gore of the zombies that had fallen from the balcony above when Isabella had sicked them through the portal, but the keep itself is still filled with dozens and dozens of the undead. They have their attention trained on the courtyard out through the broken wall that had been torn down, and floating out there is the second paladin airship. It seems that Isabella's attention is also drawn to the airship. Kula is standing next to her, along with her bodyguards. Jessica and her companions, Numb and Skull, are amongst the undead, and it, again, the focus seems to be towards the courtyard.
Does Thuftamar still have hold of Nina?
Just kind of a hand on her wrist.
All right, so I'm going to take and cast Water Whip, which I can use from my bronze-scaled scimitar, to try to whip him, and if successful, I can pull him 25 feet towards me, hopefully bringing Nina along. So
okay.
So it's a water whip spell, so you need to do a dexterity saving throw.
12.
DC 12.
Darn, okay.
You'll say I can't use luck on a spell. I guess I could, but it'd make you re-roll, but I already know the answer, so we can't do that. Okay, in that case, I'll use my movement to go all the way up and grab her other arm.
Don't do a tug of war, she'll fall apart.
Yeah, you might tear her in half. She, you know, obviously sees you and she doesn't resist you, but she now, like your presence is almost like bolstering for her, right? As she, there's clearly the recognition that she showed before when she was, you know, the soul was just put back into her shell, we'll call it. I don't know if you want to still call it a body, but because they're not all the original parts, but she'll resist now against Alamar and basically pull with you. So why don't you do a grapple? We'll do a contested grapple, and you'll have advantage with Nina's help to get her away from Thuftamar.
26.
Well, that is far and above Thuftamar's 4. As I mean, he didn't even realize you were. Like, he feels like maybe a splash of cool, refreshing water from your failed water whip as he turns. And, you know, you're already on Nina, and you've pulled her and now, you know, broken her from Thuftamar's grip. At which point, the rest of the party steps back into the Elder's Keep. You see, paint is splattered across the side of the airship that's about 30 feet above the level of the courtyard. Those words, Shaft has seen this before, the words rising for still kind of visible beneath despite the clear attempt to obscure it with a new coat. Your arrival draws everyone's attention inevitably as they kind of turn to you. And you now see that Kula has, both of his arms are held out in front of him and there's kind of a length of silk sheeting draped across his hands and his forearms. And laying on top of the silk is a long curved blade with one end ending in a jagged cut of metal. And it shines and glints in the moonlight as if it was freshly polished. Isabella turns towards you as well, and kind of in unison, every one of the dozens of undead in here turn with her as their focus shifts to the party as well.
Signate eternum.
And the portal behind you immediately seals over to stone again, closing off. You see, Jessica kind of catches Falzern's eye, or attempts to. She's waggling a finger at you, Falzern, as you enter, and she kind of gives you this needle tooth, black teeth smile.
Oh, look, Skull. They're back already. If I were them, I wouldn't have come back at all. But I ain't got no guts.
As the flaming skull's numb pipes up with his joke, Skull cackles in laughter at it. Isabella kind of addresses Shakara.
I'll be right with you, sister. Jessica, would you be so kind as to double-check for any additional visitors?
Jessica gives her a nod, and this is something that Falzern and Shaft have witnessed before, but her eyes, as if they roll back in her head, just become a completely milky white. That silvery orb, kind of amidst the turning clockwork gears suspended from the ceiling, it slides open like two eyelids to reveal this large black pupil, kind of ringed with a dark green iris with deep purple flecks. And you see it just begins to dart around the room, kind of peering at each of you around you. And Jessica's eyes move with it kind of back and forth as she's clearly controlling it.
No other visitors, Grandmother Isabella.
And the eyes kind of shift towards the courtyard and the airship. And then Jessica's eyes kind of go back to normal and that silver ball kind of closes up again.
Well, that's good news. Thank you, dear sister.
Isabella, again, kind of turns back to the ship.
Yes, go ahead. Just toss him over.
And from the side of the railing, Samuel Coltus is just sent tumbling over it by two of the paladins now as they come to the side of the ship. You see them just throw him over. His rigid form clangs and batters against the stone of the courtyard as he falls the 30 feet. The armor is still like pulsing blue. Isabella's bodyguards, the gray-clad robed figures, which you know to be flesh golems, they kind of grab each of one of his arms and just drag him and pull him up onto the stone altar that is in the courtyard below the hovering airship. You can see, like, from his nose and the corner of his mouth, now, like, blood is kind of spattered against his face from the fall. Samuel is still completely unresponsive throughout all of this. Isabella kind of, steps up to him, almost like caresses one of his cheeks, one of his blood-splattered cheeks.
So lovely to see you again, Samuel. That armor's quite fetching on you. I do hope you enjoyed wearing it while you had the chance. Now, you two boys, make sure he doesn't go anywhere, just in case.
And she'll kind of move back to where the crumbled wall, the threshold of it is, into the actual hall, the banquet hall of the keep.
What have you done to my keep, Isabella?
Oh, well, I mean, Alamash, the changes do seem a bit drastic, I'll admit, but honestly, I had thought you were dead when we started it. Surely your eternal elixir didn't put you in this.
No, the elixir was destroyed by your...
And he kind of shoots daggers over at Shakara.
Sister, before my death.
Oh my, Shakara, is this true?
I did what I thought necessary at the time.
Well, that is what I've always admired about you, Shakara. But how truly unfortunate for you, Alma. But, I mean, it all seemed to work out. You're alive, I'm alive. And you certainly look quite a bit more sprightly than you were. You've done what I asked of you, clearly. You've brought them back.
Yes, I enabled Ventrier to track our location with the sigil I applied to the armor.
But where is Ventrier? Oh, tell me, sister, you didn't kill Ventrier, did you?
No, she ran off.
Oh, good, good. I mean, I practically raised the woman. I mean, she looks to me as a mother figure. I would hate to hear of her death or some injury becoming of her.
That is interesting and good to know.
Must we prolong this? The eyes are with Shakara. I will be quite busy repairing the damage you've caused my city and its inhabitants.
Well, there's no need to be curt, Alamar. We're all friends here, right? Right, Shaft? Mia? Oh, Falzer, so nice to see you too. Well, we're all friendly. We all want the same thing, yes? We want to prevent Dendar from re-entering the world. I just simply need to open up a little peek and grab my beloved and then close it right back up. Yes?
What?
Can you do that?
I believe so. Perhaps each of you could aid me?
Do we have a choice?
Well, I mean, Shaft, I did tell you. Give you the choice that you had. I'd be happy for you to take your leave and never come back. You and Nina, of course.
So you're going to open a way out and I can just leave. No catch.
You'll have to catch a boat back to the mainland. I'm afraid the portals are now closed for business.
Can Falzerin come with me?
Well, what is it with Falzerin and numerous amounts of people wanting to keep him safe? I mean, Alamar asked me the same thing, to ensure Falzerin's survival. I saw your potential once, but now I'm not quite sure what's so special about you, Falzerin.
Falzerin sort of looks to Shaft, looks to Alamar, and then looks back to Isabella. I don't know, Isabella, but what I do know is I will not stand by and let you do this to Aspara.
Falzerin, perhaps I can bring you and maybe Mia up to speed here. I don't wish to destroy Aspara. I simply wish to get Kalar back from the prison that he shares with Dendar and Father Limic. I don't want to see the world destroyed. I live here too, you know.
And how do we know Dendar and Father Limic won't be allowed through too? Because I think that's going to be a disaster. They're banned for a reason, right?
Well, yes, I do think that you bring up a good point, Mia, that perhaps Falzon will need to stay just in case we need a, you know, a master of the arcane arts. I don't believe Alamar is quite up to snuff in his little goblin body. But you're right. We'll take every precaution to ensure that they don't get out as well.
And who is this Kalar, and what would you plan to do after this, Isabella? Just for theory's sake.
And what's wrong with Samuel? Can he get better?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Once we've placed the eyes where they need to be and assembled the scythe, he'll wake right up. And falls in, I want what anybody else wants. I want my happily ever after. It was robbed from me. Many, 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 many years ago.
And are we gonna get rid of this armor again? No one person in Aspara can have something this powerful.
Well, perhaps we can discuss that with Kalar. I mean, really, the armor is his. I certainly wouldn't want to speak on his behalf.
It was split up for a reason, though, was it not?
Yes, unfortunately, the Zelwicks and Coltises, they got to the pieces before I could safeguard them for my love, but used properly, they pose no threat to anyone.
Can I roll an insight on what she's telling me?
Absolutely.
19?
Yeah, so when she says used properly, it's that's so open-ended. Could either mean not use at all, use to actually do good, but like it's clear she has no intention of breaking up the armor or making it so the armor is unusable or anything like that.
I don't quite believe what you're saying there, Isabella. I look around to the party like, we've all talked about it. This armor's too powerful. And, I mean, well, there's obviously something wrong with it. I don't really know. Isabella, what's wrong with Samuel? Why did this armor do this to him?
Oh, well, he certainly went about the assembly process, maybe missing a few pieces here or there. You can see, as it pulses, I assume you have the eyes contained in lead, perhaps?
Correct.
Yes, yes, that would cut off their connection to the armor. It appears that you've all done this to him, actually. I had no hand in it.
So the armor is powered by the eyes?
Well, they're certainly all connected in a way. I mean, the eyes, the armor, and the scythe, it boils down to power of three, of course, you know that, sister. But Mia, I mean, perhaps I have something that would convince you to just simply hand me the eyes? Oh, Captain, and she calls up to the airship again.
You see another paladin kind of pushes Bronn to the railing. He's clearly bound, gagged, and this new captain of the old Rising Four has his blade drawn into Bronn's throat.
Now, I would never want to see any harm come to you or your family, Mia, but, you know, I had to take some precautions, and
she kind of looks over to Shaft.
Perhaps, Shaft, you might want to recalculate some of that, those percentages that we were talking about a little earlier, maybe? I think things are pretty well in my favor, yes. Oh, apologies, Shakara. The coven's favor.
I'll just give her a nod.
So, you say I can just leave with Nina?
Yes, I mean, unfortunately, you're really of no use any longer. We have all of the pieces that we need, as she kind of motions between herself and Shakara and Jessica to perform what we're all here to do.
Falzarin looks over to Shaft and says, Shaft, you can appreciate that if she has her way, she's going to be reunited with someone perhaps far more powerful than her. And Aspara is going to be under tyrannical rule of the both of them. One can only assume she means no good with this plan. You and Nina, as much as I would love for you to spend the rest of your lives together, living in peace and going about whatever you would like to do, you're not going to find a place that's comfortable and quiet with Isabella and Kalar together.
Yeah, I hear you, Falzarin.
That's simply just slander.
Isabella, I'm pretty sure that by now I know how you operate, and you do not have our good or the good of Greater Aspara in mind. You simply can't be trusted.
you have all of Aspara in mind, and every one of your intentions, day to day, minute to minute? Falzern, tell me. Surely you are this bastion of selflessness. Is that the case? Is that the case for any of you?
Well, no, Isabella. I don't claim to be perfect or that I always make the best decision.
Neither do I, Falzern.
But I will say I am not interested in amassing an immense amount of power that could cause me to have my way with the people of Aspara, essentially. That is the difference between you and I.
Well, I will tell you, not to be crude, but the only thing I wish to have my way with has been locked in a prison of ice for thousands of years, Falzern. That is all I seek.
I think I'm going to grab Nina by the hand, walk over to Falzern, look up at him, say, well, buddy, I guess it's time we're parting ways. I hope to see you again someday if you can make it through this. I hope you've learned a little something about leaving when you're supposed to be leaving, if you know what I mean. And I give him a wink, and I start walking towards the door with Nina.
And you see, like a Red Sea, the zombies part and form a path for the two of you to the southern wall with the exit to the keep.
For a moment, Falzern almost appears sort of like just stunned in awe that Shaft would do this, but then he sort of kind of tries to compose a bit of a neutral face and appear as though he's just like, you know, Shaft is a lost cause, turns back around to face Isabella.
I walk all the way over to the door, I look back at Izzy, and I go, good luck with your boyfriend. Hope everything works out for you. Mia?
Shaft.
Shakara? It's been fun. And I turn and walk out the door with her.
The rest of you kind of see stepping from through the crowd of the zombies, like they've parted now. You see zombified Tenchi, Hef, and Janella start to close the keep's doors behind Shaft, kind of amidst this horde. Now kind of split in two from Shaft's leaving.
Now, that was pleasant. That was a beautiful showing of love. That is all I want for myself. And yes, that's maybe selfish, and I may have been focused on that selfish need for years and centuries and centuries. But I'm so close. I'm so close. Shakara, please, please. The eyes, the eyes.
I'm gonna look around and be like,
I am quite impressed with your assemblage of the undead. Far surpasses anything I've been able to do so far.
Well, I certainly have had some time. I've had Jessica here to help. Surely you feel how much more strength we have when the three of us are together.
Yes, I do feel it. It is quite intoxicating.
I do say that those are the benefits of the coven. I mean, I've been trying to tell you and convince you of such for so long. I mean, I'm so glad that you joined us, and so glad to be rid of Erica, quite frankly. Falzern, you're missing out on what could have been.
I see the former elders have joined us. Where did you find them?
Oh, it wasn't very difficult at all. I mean, they were practically lost at sea. I'm not sure what went on with them, and your task, not to rub dirt in the wound, but yet another one of your failures, to bring them back to me and ensure their death, at least. You know, it slowed me down a little bit, but as you know, I clearly have many people in many places.
Yes, I'm coming to realize that. You seem to have strings that you can pull over this entire continent.
Strings that I've laid out and pulled taut again. I've had many years to do so.
Do you enjoy this? Do you enjoy getting your way by threatening people's loved ones?
I don't enjoy any of this. Mia. As I said, I...
Just like you love Kalar, I love my brother. Let him go.
And I'd be happy to do so once I have my beloved. It's as simple as that. No harm will come to Bronn. I'll certainly ensure that... And she kind of looks up to the captain. That he makes it down from the airship quite a little more softly than Samuel did.
Bring him down, now.
She kind of looks at Shigar. The eyes?
I want to see him. Is it really him?
I will start slowly walking towards Isabella.
Okay, and as you kind of, as Shigar, you make this forward progress, Isabella will signal to up to the new captain of the Rising, old Rising Four, and the ship formerly known as Rising Four. And you see they kind of tangle up Bronn in a length of rope and begin to lower him the 30 feet. The ship kind of sinks another 10 feet, so now it's only about 20, hovering 20 feet above. Again, like its wings kicking up dust and debris from the destroyed wall kind of throughout the keep. Bronn will be slowly lowered to the stone floor.
Would you like to see him, Mia?
Yes, I would, thank you. I would just want to, like, physically inspect him, make sure it's not some sort of trick, and just see if he's been taken care of, what he looks like his condition.
Okay, so Shakara, Mia, are you going to approach, like, into the courtyard together, or... Because Shakara, you're already moving towards Isabella, right?
I am going to be moving slowly. I assume Mia would be going much faster than I would.
Yeah, I'm just going to walk normally over there, just waiting for zombies to move out of the way.
Okay, and you can get to Bronn, and you can kind of untangle him and pull his gag off. Sister, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Are you okay?
I'm a little bruised up. A few knocks. Ventrier, I had asked for a ride and some paladins to Barrack, and I was rendered unconscious.
Yeah. Okay. It's you. I just had a check. Isabella wants the eyes. She was threatening to kill you.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. I, like, whisper to him. I don't know. And I just, like, very much look at Shakara and her every move.
Are you satisfied, Mia? A few cuts and scrapes. Nothing severe. Nothing serious.
I mean... I had to investigate the threat, make sure it's real.
Of course. I wouldn't have done anything less myself.
Just keep looking at Shakara.
And as will Isabella.
I will look back at Grimby and then turn back to Isabella.
After having been reunited with my love, I understand your longing.
Take a few steps closer.
I understand you believe you can free him with no other consequences.
Take another step.
I don't know that that is possible. Mayhaps together, the three of us, with perhaps Falzarin's aid, could bring about this task.
Take another step closer.
Mia trusts Shakara. She's watching intently. Like, she believes Shakara when she says she doesn't want Izzy to have the eyes, so... Letting it happen.
Falzarin is kind of just watching this happen almost, like, in slow motion, and part of him is a little bit awestruck, but also, I think, deep down, he trusts that whatever Shakara is doing is the right thing, so he's just gonna... continue to stand and watch.
As I'm walking towards Isabella, I will reach into the bag of holding. I'll pull the eyes in the lead boxes out. I will take the eyes, both eyes, out of the lead boxes. My skin will turn blue. I will elongate, and I will turn into Dendara.
As you are approaching Isabella, and, like, you can see her face kind of, like, starting to light up, right? You will have to make me a constitution saving throw as you expose yourself to the lights of the of both eyes.
How big of a radius does that have on other creatures? Like, would Isabella also have to make a check?
It's a 15-foot radius. So, yeah, as you open up, you are casting Isabella and Kula into the same radius.
23.
As you transform, you kind of shake off the immediate effects of it. But the second that they're free of the lead casing, they begin to pulse in time with Samuel in the armor of Kalar, and both of the set of armor and the eyes, the pulse begins to quicken and rapidly until it becomes like a flash as they morph into your body and you transform with them. Your coloring now, as you've transformed with both eyes uncontained in your possession for the first time, your coloring, it's like it intensifies, right? And this the sheen kind of ripples down your whole body as you extend and transform. And instead of suffering only one level of exhaustion, you will suffer now two from the transformation and with the amplified power.
Bonkers. Totally bonkers.
I guess we'll roll initiative.
Oh my goodness, what did I do?
Why am I rolling so low?
What did I do?
I am scared for Shakara. I'm also scared for Izzy, though.
You're ending the campaign one way or the other. That's what we're doing. 8 for Mia.
11 for Shakara. Sorry, Nandara.
14 for Falzrin.
At initiative count 20, Isabella will take a legendary action. And she's like taken aback by your new form.
My goodness, sister, that is amazing. I see the eyes are in there somewhere.
They are. They're safe.
Zombies will move.
Terrifying.
That is a lot of zombies.
just a wave of a tidal wave of zombies.
It's a lot. I don't know. The campaign can't end with surrender. Come on.
No.
And what's great is now Mia is pretty far away from the zombies, so fine with me. This horde of undead kind of swarms around Dendara, around Falzer and Grimby and Hulsa with their backs to the portal, the sealed off portal. But they do not attack. It was simply just a move to get them to move. Next, you see Alamar kind of skirts around these incoming zombies. They don't look like they're going after him, but he just kind of scrambles up to the about 10, 12 feet up on top of one of these rubble piles formed by the destruction of the wall. Next, Falzrin.
I think now's as good a time as ever for Falzrin to let loose his war cry. So he casts Blink. I'm surrounded, so pushed up against this stone portal behind me that I came through. So I'm going to cast Blink and hope that my magic comes through for me when it starts to activate and teleports me to safety. 13. So unless there's anything I don't know about, Falzrin blinks.
That is a successful blink. You are now on the ethereal plane.
With Dendar. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Oh, this is so much worse.
Father Limic?
I can move. Is it the beginning of my next turn I can move?
It's when you come back in, you can move up to 10 feet. You can reappear in a space up to 10 feet from where you were.
All right, that is it for Falzrin.
Next is Jessica, and you all see that she kind of pulls out this. It's like this stone. It's red. It kind of pulses slightly. It almost looks like it's in the shape of like a human heart, but clearly it's like a rock of some kind. And she too just disappears from sight. She has also appeared on the ethereal plane.
Dude, this is not cool.
Didn't see this one coming.
Nope.
And she gives you that same black needle teeth smile as she approaches you. Although going to the ethereal plane was her action, so that's kind of all she can do.
Just give her a smooch.
And next are Numb and Skull. They'll fly kind of up and over one of these rubble piles, sticking together, and both of them will actually shoot. You see their, you know, they're like these floating skulls wreathed in green flame, and their empty sockets kind of ignite, like they ignite within their wreath of flame, and these fire rays will blast out at Dendara. Two each. Adjusted 20, 17, 24, and 11.
AC is 18, so.
So two hits, 25 fire damage. And Dendara, you're next.
Just trying to figure out what I want to do. I can do a crap ton of necrotic damage, but there's a really good chance Isabella is going to be at least resistant. I will fly up into the air about 15 feet or so. I'm gonna take a chance. I'm gonna do the draining breath. I'm gonna exhale the blue energy. I'm going to position myself so that I kind of come around a little bit, and I'm now behind Isabella, so I can get her and a whole bunch of zombies with my breath.
So as you fly up, you're gonna invoke 12 opportunity attacks.
Mm-hmm.
Which you're gonna take a total of 15 slashing. As just the undead, you know, fingers worn down to skeletal digits clawing at your scales.
It is a 60-foot cone.
So that won't hit Kula. Kula still has a hold of the scythe blade.
For now, I don't want to hit Kula. I need DC 18 dex saves.
It's good DC.
Ooh, from your positioning, that cone is going to hit Grimby and Halsey.
Oh, crap.
It is very large. I mean, you can certainly easily angle it, still get Isabella, but kind of cut onto the west side of, like, the hanging eye from the clockwork.
I don't want to hit Grimby and Halsey. I do want to hit Isabella. I would prefer to not hit Kula, but if he's caught in it, then whatever.
Isabella got adjusted 20. Kula gets 16. Numb and Skull, now caught in it after you were kind of repositioned. Numb gets a 13, Skull gets an 8.
For those that failed, it is 34 points of damage, necrotic, and everybody else takes half.
I'm like trying not to even make plans, because by the time it's my turn, it's not even going to look like the same.
Your breath fully enveloping Kula completely fails this save. Immediately bloodies him as he's driven to his knees from the sapping energy of your breath. And as he does so, like, Blade of the Scythe kind of clatters against the stone next to Isabella.
Does Isabella look like she was affected at all by the breath?
Isabella's current form looks fine, although you do know that this is an illusion that you were seeing her. Other than that, so the illusion doesn't show any signs of wear or tear. But any zombie caught in your breath, like, saps them and drains them as they perish, and you essentially made about 40 more huskies with your breath. But the remaining zombies will continue to swarm around and under you and into the courtyard now.
Come to me. Come to Thor. Thor loves zombies.
Below you, Dendara, you can see them, like, reaching up and clawing up for you, but you're just too high. And the ones that dash can really only get up to Mia and Bronn. The ones on Halsey and Grimby, they're each going to be subjected, as now they can kind of move into Falzern's spot. Halsey takes 12 slashing. Grimby takes 13. Mia, you're next.
Mia's going to look at Bronn and be like, "We fight." And then she's going to channel the divinity of Thor and use her radiant soul ability. So her eyes start, you know, she's not in disguise anymore, but her eyes are extra glowing. Her incorporeal wings come out. And I will take an opportunity attack to just fly 5 feet up and start flying over towards these horde of zombies.
The grasping claw is just ineffective against your armor.
I end up being 10 feet up in the air next to Shakara in the air, sort of like getting at eye level here with Thufdamar on the pile of rubble, but like moving toward the horde of zombies, and that's my action. Okay, so I'm going to use a third level spell slot. So I move my spiritual weapon and call it right next to Kula and Izzy, and I swing at Izzy with a 28 to hit, and then 12 force damage.
So no channel just yet.
I wasn't close enough.
Right, you had to get into position.
I want to get as many zombies as possible.
Next is Isabella. Finally, Isabella drops her guise. That portly, kind of older woman shimmers and flickers, replaced with her large hag form, that gray, stretched skin over thick, muscly arms with a large, rounded, hunched back covered in brambles and sticks woven into tatters of stitched flesh for clothing, skulls of humanoids and horned beasts kind of amidst all of it in like this brambly mass. She reaches back into like that mess, that nest back, grabs a hold of one of the protruding branches, pulling on it and pulling on it to produce this gnarled, twisted 5-foot length. And it ends with a jagged piece of perfectly polished metal. She stoops to pick up the discarded blade from as Kula had dropped it. Both pieces of Father Limick's scythe, they begin to hum and vibrate. And you can see, like, they start to vibrate so hard that they become blurred. The vibrations start to spread up her arms to her shoulder, like across her entire body as she's gripping these. And she's clearly grimacing, and like she starts to blur too as the vibrations shake her entire body. And the scythe pieces, they begin to glow red hot. The heat kind of blasts it over those in the immediate proximity, and the wind of the airship further sending these radiance of heat into the hall. The humming intensifies and it grows louder and louder as she gets the pieces closer and closer. Isabella is grunting and straining to keep them both still long enough to cease the vibration, long enough to line up those jagged edges of the metal. And they fuse together as soon as they make contact. The humming's crescendo blasts out at the point of this fusion. And anybody in a 30-foot radius can make me a DC, a constitution saving throw, please. So that's going to be Saftamar, Mia, Dendara, Brawn, a bunch of zombies. Also look like Skull as well.
15 for Dendara.
11 for Mia.
Brawn gets 15 as well. Those are all fails. And you are each now deafened for 1 minute. You can make another constitution saving throw at the end of your turn to get rid of the effect. Now I suppose you two, the ones that are deafened, cannot hear what Isabella is saying. But she, those that can, I guess Falzer, and you can still hear on the ethereal plane. You hear her say, and she's like pointing to her robed bodyguards.
Be dears and grab the tripods, would you?
And as she's kind of pointing at Dendara. But she will take a swipe at Dendara with the scythe. So 15 feet. Isabella's new hag form is a 10 by 10, and she has... She does have the reach with the scythe. Just barely. 21 to hit.
21 hits.
32 slashing. Paladins are next. I suppose those that can hear would hear a familiar humming coming from the deck of the ship. Mia, Dendara, and Brawn, this would probably be a little out of Falzrin's range of view from the ethereal plane, but you see more ropes thrown over the side of the ship and paladins lowering themselves down into the courtyard.
Shakara is not looking good right now. Or sorry, Dendara is not looking good right now.
Got all my spell slots left to revive you.
That's good to know.
Like, haven't used one spell slot yet.
Halsa, surrounded with Grimby still. She's just frantically trying to Eldritch Blast these zombies around her. Unfortunately at disadvantage with both of her beams, which go wild. But Grimby right next to her, you see he like bellows and enters his rage. And as he does so, being like a storm barbarian. Nothing as impressive as what Mia might wield, but a little bolt of lightning kind of lances out into and fries one of these zombies in front of Halsa. And he just takes his axe and will begin to cleave through, bisecting three of these zombies in front of him, just cleaving through each of them. Finally, last in initiative are Isabella's flesh golems. And each of them walks over and grabs a hold of one of the tripods, picking them up, and they kind of fold them together, right? The legs kind of folding in together, and they hurl them at Dendara as if they were javelins.
Interesting.
Oh, so if they stick in her skin, the, like, ship weapon goes to them or something?
No, they're the thing that the eyes are supposed to be in, right?
Yeah, somehow we'll still channel the focus of the eyes.
Oh, no.
A 21 and an 11. But I still have some patron inspiration left. So I'm going to use the next in my list and re-roll that miss. This one's for you, Siam. An 18.
Both hit.
Okay, so you're just going to take another 10 piercing as they jab into you.
Does Dendara get the negative 3 to bludgeoning, piercing, slashing damage that Shakara got?
That's a good question. Yeah, I mean, I pretty much give you everything else, I'm sure.
Good answer, good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Dendara falters in the air a little bit. She's not looking good.
Do we know if this is like a condition with temporary hit points? Like, we didn't really have time to talk about it, I guess.
No, not really. As the tripods kind of jab into you, Dendara, you begin to glow. And the glow kind of moves up the length of the tripods to the tip of them and then blasts into Samuel, into the armor of Kalar, and now Samuel forming the one point of a triangle. You, Dendara, yourself serving as one of the lengths, the two beams of blue as the second and third side. Samuel's eyes shoot open. Ooh. He like kind of starts to, as if he like tries to stand up and like he's got something heavy on his chest as he's struggling to get up from the altar. The robed figures now move back to him, attempting to like keep him still as Samuel fights against them.
And that's our show. If you're not already, be sure to follow us at IncorrigiblePar on Twitter, Incorrigible Party on Instagram and Facebook, and you can go to incorrigibleparty.com for world lore and PC information, and we've recently started adding some maps there as well. Incorrigible Party is generously sponsored and made possible by Critical Hit Design. For any of your design needs, visit criticalhitdesign.com. All ambient sound and music is provided by Tabletop Audio, and our intro and outro music was created by Josh Jarvis. You can reach him at jamesmercymusic@gmail.com. Happy adventuring!
This has been a Sounds of Steel production.